The only guy that I ever talked to when I was talking to those UFO people that I believed about UFOs was a guy who was at Skinwalker Ranch. That whole area out there has a shitload of UFO sightings.
What's Skinwalker Ranch?
It's some place that this guy, Robert Bigelow, owns. And he's a what makes it compelling is he actually is an aerospace investor. And he's got a company that makes all these parts and shit for different spaceships and different pods and things. Why does he do them? I mean, it's his business. But he also owns this gigantic ranch in Utah. And we went out to visit him, visit the ranch, and visit some of the people around there. And one guy that we talked to that lived around there was just regular dude. I think he worked in a factory, just a regular guy, not crazy, but super normal. Like, talk to him. Not a bullshit artist at all. And he's telling me about this glowing orb that came through the walls of his house and floated around inside of his living room and kitchen and then took off through the wall. And I said, oh, like the way he described it, I absolutely believe that he was telling me the truth. And I think that was ball lightning. I think they have it a lot in that area. And so I think whatever the atmospheric conditions in that area, it's a frequent occurrence. And because of that, a lot of these people see things and then they start talking and then people start looking for them and then they start talking crazy. And then people start talking about, like, they were talking about a bulletproof wolf that appeared out of mist. And, like, for real. That was like,
you've got that out front.
Oh, the
That's
werewolf?
Your greeter.
Yeah.
That's the bulletproof wolf.
Yeah. But this guy was the only guy that made sense. And I think he saw ball lightning, just like you did.
But how could it be on the ground like that?
It could just happen, you know, if there's a storm conditions. But it does, it occurs not just up in the sky. It occurs at low altitude as well. Yeah, you know, they say ball. They don't know why. Apparently, I talked to a scientist about this. He was telling me that lightning shouldn't be possible. Like, there shouldn't be enough power to create lightning. There's like, if you do the calculations, he's like, but clearly we know it's true. So what do we do about that? We don't really know. We don't know enough about lightning. So when you describe ball lightning, he's like, well, good fucking luck. Who knows? What are the atmospheric conditions?
We don't know enough about it.
Yeah, we don't know what the conditions are. Like, what causes it?
What does that mean there's not enough energy for lightning? You can't marshal that much electricity in the atmosphere?
I'm too stupid to repeat what he said and have it make any sense. But when he was describing it to me, the way he was explaining it, and I think I read it as well. He was explaining, and what I read was that they don't really understand how that much energy is produced in the sky like that. And that if you calculated, like, what it would take to produce that shouldn't be possible. Again, I'm a moron. So talking about
that. No, I wish the expert were here because, that's fascinating.
Yeah. So what this guy was describing, was talking about ball lightning. They were saying they don't know how to recreate ball lightning. They have no idea what causes it, but they're sure it's a real thing.
Wait, we can't recreate ball lightning in a lab environment?
I don't believe so.
That's crazy.
Yeah. But I don't think they can recreate.
You know, you're right, because we can't generate that amount of power.
Yeah.
We literally can't generate, I mean, maybe with a bomb, but we can't generate that.
I don't know. I have no idea.
I think we can't.
But I think that's what a lot of people are seeing. I think these people that see things, and then also the human imagination is so fantastic. Your memory's all fucked up. Memory's terrible. You know, so you see something, and then you decide it's something different,
yes.
And then you see it. I talked to another lady who told me she saw Bigfoot. And she wasn't she didn't seem like a bullshit artist. She seemed like she was being 100% honest. She didn't seem like she needed a ton of attention. She didn't seem crazy. And I think she saw a bear. I just think she saw a bear way in the distance, and she saw it very briefly because it was the Pacific Northwest and trees are very dense. I think she saw a big, and it might even have been on two legs because bears do that all the time.
They do that.
And I think she saw that, and in her mind, she saw a gorilla. It was, why am I looking at a gorilla? And then she had this story that just got concocted in her head, and she saw Sasquatch.
That happens. I mean, I'm convinced of certain things, and then I find out I'm completely wrong.
Like
you
ghosts?
Know, that does happen.